Hey, this is Heather from the Renaissance English History Podcast, and this is your Tudor Minute for July the 22nd. Today in 1536, Henry VIII's illegitimate son by Bessie Blunt, Henry Fitzroy, Duke of Richmond, died at St. James's Palace, probably of tuberculosis. He was just 17. Coming just 2 months after the execution of Anne Boleyn, this was another blow for Henry. By all accounts, he loved his son and was very proud of him, so it was a personal loss. But he had also just made both of his daughters illegitimate, and he now didn't even have the option of making his son his legitimate heir. According to the chronicler Charles Risley, Richmond became sickly sometime before he died, although his biographer, Beverly Murphy, says that he was in several public appearances and activities in April and May that year, and nobody commented on his health. For example, he had attended Anne Boleyn's execution, and nobody said that he looked sick. He was reported ill with consumption in early July, and then he died a few weeks later. The Duke of Norfolk gave orders that the body be wrapped in lead and then taken to a closed cart for secret interment, but his servants put the body in a straw-filled wagon. The only mourners were two attendants who followed at a distance. He now has an ornate tomb in Framlingham Church in Suffolk. His father, Henry VIII, outlived him by over a decade and was succeeded by his legitimate son, Edward, who was born to Jane Seymour just over a year after Henry Fitzroy died. It's said that Henry Fitzroy might have been made king had Henry VIII died without a legitimate son. There's a quote by Thomas Fuller that says, "Well, it was for them that Henry Fitzroy, his natural son, was dead. Otherwise, some suspect, had he survived King Edward VI, we might presently have heard of a King Henry IX, so great was his father's affection and so unlimited his power to prefer him." That's your Tudor Minute for today. Remember, you can dive deeper into life in 16th century England through the Renaissance English History Podcast at englandcast.com.